Welcome back everyone. In this lecture we'll learn about linear position invariant degradations, and then we'll learn about estimation of degradation model. In that we'll learn about estimation by image observation, estimation by experiment, and estimation by modeling. Let us now understand linear position invariant degradations. So if we look at the degradation model, it is given as g of xy equal to h of f of xy plus eta of xy. Here h of f of xy is the degradation function and eta of xy is the additive noise. And for this linear position invariant degradations, what we will do is we'll consider that there is no additive noise. That means in the absence of additive noise, we'll set eta of xy equal to 0. That means g of xy is given as g of xy is equal to h of f of xy. It's only because of the degradation function h. And for any scalar values a and b, the function h is linear if it satisfies this equation. Okay, so h of whole into this square bracket a f1 of x comma y plus b into f2 of x comma y is equal to, we can separate them. Okay, so we can take this h function inside. So a into h of f1 comma xy plus b into h of f2 of x comma y. So you can separate them if it is linear. Then we'll check for the position invariant condition. So an operator having input output relationship g of xy is equal to h of f of xy is said to be position invariant if h of f of x minus alpha comma y minus beta is equal to g of x minus alpha comma y minus beta for any value of f of xy and any alpha and beta. This definition indicates that the response at any point in the image depends only on the value of the input at that point, not on its position. So this is what we mean by position invariant. F of xy can be expressed as f of xy is equal to double integral from minus infinity to plus infinity of f of alpha comma beta into delta of x minus alpha comma y minus beta d alpha d beta. Using this definition, we can write g of xy is equal to h of f of xy, which is equal to h of f of xy. F of xy value we are substituting here, so which is equal to double integral, this equation we are writing here inside, for eta equal to 0, additive noise is equal to 0. And here we are assuming h is linear, and using the integral linearity, we can write g of xy is equal to double integral minus infinity to infinity of h of f of alpha comma beta into delta of x minus alpha comma y minus beta into d alpha d beta. And if you simplify it further, g of xy is equal to double integral minus infinity to infinity f of alpha comma beta h of delta of x minus alpha comma y minus beta into d alpha d beta. And here the term h of x comma alpha comma y comma beta, which is equal to h of delta of x minus alpha comma y minus beta, is called as the impulse response. And in other words, if eta of xy is equal to 0, then h of x comma alpha comma y comma beta is the response of h to an impulse of strength 1 at coordinates x comma y. In optics, the impulse becomes a point of light and h of x comma alpha comma y comma beta is commonly referred to as the point spread function or SPF. This name arises from the fact that all physical optical systems blur a point to some degree, with some amount of blurring being determined by the quality of optical components. We can further simplify g of xy as g of xy is equal to double integral f of alpha comma beta into h of x comma alpha comma y comma beta alpha d beta. So this equation is called as the superposition integral of first kind, or also called as a Fredholm integral of first kind. This expression is a fundamental result that is at the core of linear system theory. It states that if the response of h to an impulse is known, then the response to any input f of alpha comma beta can be calculated by this. In other words, in a linear system, h is completely characterized by its impulse response. And if h is position invariant, then we can write g of xy is equal to double integral f of alpha comma beta into h of x minus alpha comma y minus beta d alpha d beta. This expression is called the convolution integral. It is a continuous variable of the discrete convolution expression. This integral tells us that knowing the impulse response of a linear system allows us to compute its response g to any input f. The result is simply the convolution of the impulse response and the input function. And in the presence of additive noise, we can write g of xy is equal to double integral f of alpha comma beta into h of x comma alpha comma y comma beta d alpha d beta plus eta of x comma y. And if h is position invariant, then we can write g of xy is equal to double integral f of alpha comma beta into h of x minus alpha comma y minus beta d alpha d beta plus eta of x comma y. Here, the values of noise term eta of xy are random and are assumed to be independent of position. Using the familiar notation for convolution, we can write g of xy is equal to h of xy convolution f of xy plus eta of xy. And in frequency domain, we can write capital G of uv equal to h, again it's capital, to represent frequency domain, h of uv into f of uv plus n of uv. So here note the term, in spatial domain it is convolution, frequency domain it is multiplication. So because degradations are modeled as convolution, image restoration is often called image deconvolution. The filters used in the restoration process are called as deconvolution filters. Next up is the estimation of degradation model. So the degradation model is given by g of xy is equal to f of xy convolution h of xy plus eta of x comma y. Here it is convolution, and in frequency domain we can rewrite the equation as g of uv equal to f of uv into h of uv plus n of uv. Here it is multiplication in frequency domain. Now, the purpose of estimation is to estimate the degradation function h of xy or h of uv. And why we need to estimate h of xy or h of uv is because if we know exactly what this h of xy is, regardless of noise, we can do deconvolution to get f of xy back from g of xy. Okay, so as we know, g of xy is the degraded image and f of xy is the original image. Okay, so we are performing deconvolution to get back f of xy with this technique. And the methods that we can use to estimate a degradation function is estimation by image observation, or we can go for estimation by experiment, or we can go for estimation by modeling. So first type of estimation is estimation by image observation. Suppose that we are given a degraded image without any knowledge about degradation function H. One way to estimate this function is to gather information from the image itself. For example, if the image is blurred, we can look at a small section of the image containing simple structures like a part of an object and the background. In order to reduce the effect of noise in our observation, we can look for areas of strong signal content. Using simple gray levels of the object and background, we can construct an unblurred image of the same size and characteristics as the observed image. Okay, let us see one example for this. So here we have a input image which is unknown to us, okay, which is given by this f of xy. And because of degradation function h of xy, what we get is the degraded image, which is given by g of xy. And note that we are in acquisition of this degraded image, and this original image is unknown to us. Okay, now we need to operate on this degraded image, and we need to estimate this h of xy to get back this original image f of xy. Okay, let us see how to do that. So we'll consider a small portion of the degraded image. Basically, we take this sub image. Okay, so this is the sub image, and we can clearly see some foreground and the background. Then basically we can call it as GS of xy, G sub image of xy, and we can do the restoration process by estimation. Okay, so by using all the techniques that we know, we can try to estimate the sub image like this. So this gives us somewhat clear version of this sub image. Now we are satisfied with this, with some trial and error we arrive at this image. What we can do is with this restructured image in hand, and we call it as f cap s of xy. It's the estimate, okay? Cap is for estimate. So we can take the DFT of sub image, which gives us GS of UV, and we can take the DFT of this reconstructed sub image, F cap S of UV. Then we can estimate the transfer function using this relationship, H of UV, which is approximately equal to HS of UV, which is equal to G of UV by F cap of UV. This is how we estimate the degradation function by using image observation. Okay, and in this, so this part is the observation part, okay, given by this blue square rectangle. And this is used when we know only G of XY and we cannot repeat the experiment. And for that part, we have the second type. So here is the second type, which is estimation by experiment. So if equipment similar to the equipment used to acquire the degraded image is available, it is possible in principle to obtain an accurate estimate of the degradation. Images similar to the degradation image can be acquired with the various system settings until they are degraded as closely as possible to the image we wish to restore. Then the idea is to obtain the impulse response of the degradation by imaging an impulse, basically a small dot of light, using the same system settings. So basically what we can do is we have a input impulse image, and we take the system response of it, and we get the response from the system like this. Okay. And basically the impulse is simulated by a bright dot of light, as bright as possible to reduce the effect of noise. And these are the representation in a spatial domain, impulse A into delta of xy, and degraded image is basically g of xy. And we can recall that Fourier transform of an impulse is a constant. So if you take the DFT on both sides, and for this impulse, DFT of this impulse function is constant A, and G of x y DFT is basically G of uv. And you can estimate the degradation function by basically G of uv by A. So this gives the degradation function. This is how we perform estimation by experiment. So third type is the estimation by modeling, and it is used when we know physical mechanism underlying the image formation process that can be expressed mathematically. And a simple example we can think of is the atmospheric turbulence model, which is given by this equation: h of uv is equal to e raised to minus k into u square plus v square raised to 5 by 6. And here the value of k affects how the image appearance changes. So this is the original image, and if you put k equal to 0.0025, you get the severe turbulence effect like this. And if you reduce the k value slightly to 0.001, you get mild turbulence effect. And if you reduce it further to 0.0025 like this, you get low turbulence image. So this is a simple atmospheric turbulence model. Another type of modeling example we can think of is motion blurring effect, where there is a relative motion between the camera and the object that we are capturing. So let us assume that the camera velocity is x naught of t comma y naught of t, and the blurred image is obtained by g of x y is equal to 0 to t of f of x plus x naught of t comma y plus y naught of t dt. Here t is basically the exposure time, and you can write g of uv is equal to double integral from minus infinity to infinity of g of x y into e raised to minus j 2 pi ux plus uy dx dy. And here we can substitute for g of x y. G of x y is given by this equation, so you substitute it here and write the exponential term outside. Okay, then we can reversing the order of integration here, integral terms, take this 0 to t outside and double integral inside, and rearrange the terms, you get this equation. So in the last equation, the term inside the outer brackets given by red color here is the Fourier transform of the displaced function f of x minus x naught of t comma y minus y naught of t. So if you simplify it, then you can write it as 0 to t of f of uv into e raised to minus j 2 pi of u x naught of t plus v into y naught of t dt. And if you take the f term f of uv outside, f of uv into 0 to t of e raised to minus j 2 pi u x naught of t plus v of y naught of t dt. So then we get motion blurring transfer function, which is given by h of uv equal to 0 to t of e raised to minus j 2 pi u x naught of t plus v y naught of t dt. And for a constant motion, we can write x naught of t comma y naught of t is equal to at comma bt. And h of uv for that is integral 0 to t of e raised to minus j 2 pi ua plus uv ub into dt, which is equal to t by pi ua plus uv into sine pi of ua plus uv into e raised to minus j pi of ua plus vb. So the last equation was the equation for constant motion. We'll rewrite it here. So which is h of uv, which is equal to t by pi into ua plus vb into sine of pi into ua plus vb into e raised to minus j pi of ua plus vb. So here is the example of applying that equation here. So original image, digital image processing is clearly visible here. Now if you apply that equation with a equal to b equal to 0.1, we put the value of a and b equal to 0.1 and t equal to 1. So this is the effect. So it is giving you a motion blurring effect. So this is the application of this example, application of this equation. So in this lecture, we have looked at linear position invariant degradations, estimation of a degradation model. In that we learned about estimation by image observation, estimation by experiment, and then estimation by modeling. In the next lecture, we'll learn about inverse filtering and minimum mean square error filtering, which is the Wiener filtering. See you at the next lecture. Thank you.